Hi, this is Anthony from AG Autosports. We're out here at FL2K 2020 for the Karma Evo. Pretty much we decided to put the car back together. Last minute project, we built the car in 3 weeks. It's utilizing a lot of factory parts from the shop that was just laying around. We pieced it together. It's got an AG spec 2.2 liter aluminum rod race motor. Same motor we're running in the Dan TRC Silver Evo. Out there whooping everybody on the streets. I mean, we pretty much built the car, like I said, overnight. No goals to set or you know times to beat or anything. We just came out to race and have fun. Our AG spec 2.2 liter long block is utilizing Manly 94 millimeter 2.2 liter stroker crank with GRP aluminum custom rods and a custom AG spec 2.2 liter piston that we designed. It was a new piston we were testing out, and it seems to be actually working very, very well for us. So the short block is, you know, all of our specs, but nothing, you know, out of the realm. Everything, you know, real simple. Factory bore, everything is pretty straightforward on it. Chris Speed, the in-house tuner, the magic man, he built the whole harness and everything for the car in a few days time. We're running the Haltech Nexus, all the new Nexus ECU and all the CAN system software and everything. Pretty much everything in the drivetrain stock. We have a PPG gear set, a carbon drive shaft. Everything else is factory. Stock axles, stock diffs, stock everything, subframes. There's no strain gauge, no nothing in the car. We're actually pretty surprised to run a 830 pass on such a small setup. As a Zona Rotor 10569S turbocharger, which we're actually very impressed with. 44 PSI, and the car is really impressive right now in my eyes. Ran the whole weekend so far and have done nothing but add fuel to the car. Just keep going. Some of our close friends here are neighboring partners with the shop, Rich Auto Works from Raw Racing. He stepped up really well and helped us with all the last minute fabrication work on the car. The car is not running anything crazy. It's a 4-injector setup, has a Skunk 2 intake manifold, has a ID 2600 cc injectors with a Aeromoto mechanical fuel pump. Very, very simple as far as everything else goes. 3-inch intercooler piping, Treadstone intercooler. It's got a Dan TRC heart inside of the Karma AG Autosports Evo. There we go. His car really inspired me to put the car back together. We retired it, and after 2 years, we took his car and seen some really crazy numbers with it. So I decided just to put his heart in this shell and see what it could do. Yeah, this setup is completely different than our old setup. We were running an 86 millimeter turbo on methanol, 16 injectors, everything billet and as big as we could get, you know, 80, 90 pounds of boost. And it's kind of crazy to see such a small, tiny frame turbocharger on 44 pounds of boost make 1125 horsepower on this setup. It's kind of mind-blowing to me. Very, very simple, easy power, and it's probably the funnest, easiest race car I've ever built, like we've ever built. You know, the whole team, Johnny from AG, my right-hand man, helped me get the car all done. You know, Chris Speed really, really put in his effort this time on the wiring and tuning and all the electronics in the car. Brian from Extreme Motorsports stepped up, he helped. Rich Auto Works was all night last minute, definitely trying to help us get everything ready. You know, Haltech really helped out overnighting last minute parts and everything, so everything is working out really well for us so far. I can't wait to see what is in the next few weeks to come. You know, as far as the weekend goes, we didn't come out here with any expectations. We put the car on the track the very, very first hit out. The car went 840, which was kind of nothing what I expected the car to do. We went up for our next pass, the car went 833. We went up for our third pass, the car spun really, really hard and still went 840. We progressively got better on our 60 foots, even with some, you know, off-the-shelf D2 suspension that we're using right now. None of the guys had, you know, time to get us any drag suspension in time because we pieced the car together just within a few weeks. You know, there was no order time for the suspension. So in the next couple weeks to come, we're gonna finish dialing the car in and try to see what it does at the next event.